So Alhamdulillah, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this blessed day. So everybody say Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. And I'd like to congratulate everyone on this blessed, on this happy day. So inshallah we all should have a smile on our face. So even put a fake smile on your face. Look at each other and smile. Okay, and smiling is a sunnah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would always have a smile on his face. Regardless of how much difficulty, trials and tribulations he would go through. In fact, his whole life, right from birth, was just full of trials and tribulations. The amount of hardship he went through, we cannot even comprehend. Entire life, literally. You know, this is why we should study the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this made him strong. Allah prepared him. Those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to use for great service of deen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them difficulties, trials and tribulations, makes them strong, makes them patient, so that they can handle anything. He was an orphan, his father passed away, his mother passed away, his uncle passed away. All sorts of hardship. Then after prophethood, the amount of abuse he was facing from his own people, subhanallah. He Allah made him very, very strong. So those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to accept for the service of deen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them calamities and hardships. أشد الناس بلاء الأنبياء فالأمثل ثم الأمثل من الناس. That those people who face the most hardship are the Anbiya, and then those who follow them. So, you know, in spite of all our hardships, difficulties that we may face in life, we should forget all that and we should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, respected brothers, today is our Eid day. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we smile, and you know, even if we have any hardships, we forget all that and we always keep a smile on our face. Like our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam just mentioned. In spite of all his hardships, trials, he would still have a smile on his face. Comes the hadith, when he's alone, he would be in constant concern. He was da'imul fikr. He was always worried. Not stressed, not depressed, but worried in deep thought. Whenever he was alone, he was seen sitting alone, he would be in deep thought, thinking about the state of the ummah. He would be constantly remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kana Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yadhkuru Allah ta'ala fi kulli ahyanihi. He would always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then as soon as he would see someone, straight away he would smile, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, and he would be so happy. So we should, you know, we should inculcate this sunnah. And on a day like this, Eid day, it's our happiest day. We should be very happy. Any grudges that we have, we should forget about that. Any problems, illnesses, thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon every single situation he's given us. You know, he says, for deen, in regards to your deen, you should always look at those who are better than you, above you. Who's a hafid, who's a alim, who's spending in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has given him wealth and he's spending night and day in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't ever envy or look up to a person with wealth. A person with wealth, driving nice car, living in big houses, how is that going to help you, benefit you? There's nothing to respect a person for his wealth. You know, how is it going to benefit you? He's not giving you a single penny. Yes. But if that person, Allah's given him wealth, and he is spending his money night and day, then this is the person worth envying. Envying meaning not out of hatred, but wishing, wish I had money like him so that I can spend in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wish I was in his position. Another person, a person whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given the Qur'an. And that person recites the Qur'an night and day. These are the two people we can actually envy. Other than that, we shouldn't envy anybody. We shouldn't look up to the wealth of anybody else. So, inshallah, today we celebrate because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given us the tawfiq to fast for a whole month. This is what this Eid is. It's our celebration, celebrating our happiness of being given the tawfiq to fast for a whole month. All of us, we've made so much sacrifice. You know, the amount of sacrifice that we've made in this 1 month. We normally can't even make this much sacrifice in the whole year. Imagine, fasting all day, in the long days, then doing Qiyamul Layl, and today is the day of our awards. Today is the day of, it's the award ceremony day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us all our reward for the whole month of Ramadan. So we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala excessively. The more we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more He would bless us. Alhamdulillah, we are praying our first Eid Salah in this masjid. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us this beautiful masjid. And as I mentioned in Bengali as well, we should not forget our elders who made so much effort after coming to this country, coming to this area, in shaping this community, in establishing the masjid. Alhamdulillah, due to their effort, people like myself and many other young brothers, you know, whose parents might have left this world, you know, they've gone and studied deen. It's because of the effort they did. Had they not established this masjid in creating this community, like many, many other people in even Muslim countries, they're just Muslim by name. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us a tawfiq to go out, learn the deen, come back and serve our community. So I myself, you know, extremely grateful. I thank the committee, specifically, mashallah, you know, Anubai asked me to come. And I'm really, really grateful that, you know, I am able to come back and, you know, say a few words, which will hopefully benefit myself first and foremost, and will benefit others. And inshallah, we'll get a sadaqah jariya. So it's a, you know, a great privilege and honor for myself. Speaking of others, today, in our happy day, we must not forget our loved ones who have left this world. We must not forget the poor people around the world. In Islam, we never ever celebrate any happiness without thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first and foremost. And secondly, without considering the poor around us. And this is the whole reason why the Sadaqatul Fitr was made wajib upon every single Muslim who has enough wealth on which he gives zakat, so that our poor people could also enjoy their Eid. And whilst we're celebrating, being very, very happy, we must not forget our obligations to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our obligations to our fellow Muslims, to the poor. And especially at difficult times like this, you know, we should not become totally negligent. Right now, we are going through hard times in this country and all over the world. In this country, with the recent attacks, the Islamophobia. You know, we Muslims, we should be very, very, very cautious. We should do a lot of istighfar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because whatever calamity comes upon us, it's because of our sin. ظَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِ النَّاسِ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِ النَّاسِ لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْدَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا. That whatever facade that is prevalent on this earth is because of the evil that people have committed with their hands. So we should do istighfar. When calamity comes, it comes upon everyone. If we see anybody committing haram, we should also advise them. And most importantly, at the times like this, we should be united. Man shadda shudda fi nar. Whoever tries to cause divisions will be thrown into the fire of hell. Ittabi'u sawad al-adam. Always follow the majority of the ummah. Lan tajtami'a ummati ala dalalatin. The ummah will never ever unite upon any misguidance. So this is ijma, the concept of ijma, following the majority, the mainstream Muslims, the majority of the ulama, a'imma of the ummah. Any issue, any approach, anything, a way of life that the majority of the ulama are upon, we must not oppose that. Those who oppose that, they are causing ikhtilaf firqa within the community. So likewise in our community as well, we should do things together, you know, and this concept of just trying to infiltrate different communities, the mainstream Muslims, and promoting your ideologies and always opposing the mainstream ulama and the salafus salihin, the a'imma of the ulama of this ummah, is a sign of the khawarij, it's a sign of deviance. This is a form of causing disunity. You know, people, if there's so much disunity here, the local imams providing tafsir, education, but no, it's not enough just because it's not according to your understanding. So you want to oppose that and you want to set up your own one right next door to the masjid or in the same masjid, do other things. This is just causing friction. So we must not have this attitude. Our local ulama, our local people have right. And this was the approach of the Salaf. We see every ulama, tabi'in, who was in a particular area, they would follow the madhab, they would follow the fatawa and the teachings of the sahaba, of the imam of this time. So especially brothers, we should, you know, be united, we should follow the jama'ah and, you know, put aside our differences and not try to just infiltrate and, you know, cause friction in the ummah. We should respect our ulama, the teachers of our fathers. It's because of their effort we are who we are today. It's because of our elders. Yes, nobody is perfect. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a tawfiq to act upon what has been said. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us happy all our lives, fulfill all our needs, make it easy for us to accomplish our goals of this world and in the hereafter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us united. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. There's two donation boxes outside. The white one is for the fitra. So if anybody wants to give their fitra, they can still give the fitra. I'll make sure you put it into the white box. Inshallah, the bucket is going to go round now. So everybody, please donate generously, wholeheartedly. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Sunnah to donate on Yawmul Eid. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also did that as well. After the Eid Salah, he encouraged people to tasaddaqu, tasaddaqu. As-sadaqatu tutfi'u ghadab al-Rab. Sadaqa extinguishes the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sadaqatu tadfa'u al-baliyyat. Sadaqa is the means of repelling calamities. So he went to the ladies and he encouraged them. He advised them not to be ungrateful to their husbands, not to curse constantly, because a lot of women will, may Allah protect us, may Allah protect them, will go to the fire of hell because of being ungrateful to their husbands and for cursing one another excessively. And he told them to give sadaqah. By giving sadaqah, these shortcomings that we have, the bad habits that we have, you know, because of our shortcomings, how we talk, how we speak, how we behave with people, how we stand, you know, how we look at people, you know, all sorts of things, these are, you know, might hurt someone. You know, we should always give sadaqah, so that with the sadaqah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives these minor sins of us, or sins that we, you know, mistakes that we make all the time. So please donate generously. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our donations. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Inshallah, after the collections completed, we're going to start our Salah, Salatul Eid. So we all make intention of praying two rak'at wajib salah of Salatul Eid with six extra takbirat. According to the Hanafi school of thought, we do six extra takbirat in the first rak'at before the qira'ah, and in the second rak'at after the qira'ah, and then we go into ruku'. And rest of the salah is the same. According to other imams, they're slightly different. They do more takbirs. And it's all from the Quran and Sunnah. Nobody is following any of the imams. Everybody is following the Quran and Sunnah. Those who say they're following a madhab, they're not following any particular imam. This is a very misconception which is being spread, and people are being manipulated and made confused. Nobody is following the imams. If you're going to say by following the imam, you're not following the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then in that case, nobody is following the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Even those who say that we only follow the Quran and Sunnah, they're not following the Quran and Sunnah because they are following Google or they're following someone from YouTube. How many people who claim we are following Quran and Sunnah actually study the tafsir directly from the Arabic text? How many people actually scrutinize every single hadith with its authenticity? They're just following Imam Bukhari. Right? So these imams, they're not saying things from their pocket. They are saying from the Quran and Hadith. And they are the most learned about the Quran and Hadith. And this is the reason why they are known as the imams. They're the imams of the Khairul Qurun. They're the imams of the best of nations. So if they're the imams of the best of nations, aren't they more worthy of being followed? Their fatwa being more worthy of being followed than my fatwa, or someone like myself, or someone contemporary? And this concept